Vice President of Marketing, Shell Lubricants Americas. All right, good evening. Let me first say that on behalf of everyone at Shell Lubricants, how proud we are and how honored we are to be a part of tonight's Hall of Fame induction ceremony and special recognition event. And extremely delighted to be able to honor and recognize four-time Indy 500 winner, Rick Mears. Let's take a quick look at a tribute to Rick.
Here's young Rick Mears, a newcomer to racing who, as a part-time driver of the SC team, was named Co-Rookie of the Year in 1977. On the pole, Rick Mears, better known for fast speeds and rugged off-road desert races.
Thank you.
greatest brand ambassadors you have for Pittsville. You never thought to talk about Johnny Rutherford brought the first yellow submarine to the victory circle, but you did it again in 84 and 88. And I think since then, I mean, you've continued to inspire not only staff at Pittsville, but our customers, our consumers, and we know race fans all around the world. And we actually know that one of those race fans grew up and became a driver, and now you coach him. So he's going to have an opportunity to take the yellow submarine into the victory circle. So very excited about that. But and we know this is going to be a special year for you, not only with the 100 running, with the special recognition tonight, but also with Roger and Roger's 50th anniversary. So I tell you, we wanted to do something to show you how much we appreciate the support you give us and the support that Roger gives us. So I hope you guys would allow, Pittsville would like to donate $50,000 in your name and Roger's name to the Paralyzed Veterans of America. We know how important that organization is to you. So if I could, maybe after the tonight's ceremony, I'd have you come back to stage to Roger if you wouldn't mind coming up. And we've got Colin Abraham, the president of Pittsville, and our veterans from the Paralyzed Veterans will come up and we'll do something afterwards at the end. But again, just thank you for all your support you've given us, and best of luck this weekend and hope that Helio take the whole summer into the nation. All right, thank you.
I'll go over here and I'll say success.
Well, thank you very much, Rusty, and that's great. That is great. We really appreciate it. Thank you. That's a great deal to do.
Most of the voices calling your wins were called Paige. Thank you for winning number four so that I could call one. I appreciate that. That first picture that we saw in the video, what were you, 12 when that was?
14, I think.
14. Well, we've got a lot of other people coming up here in a few moments to talk with you and about you, but just in a nutshell, if you would please tell us how this association between Roger
Hall began. Well, really, it's been a long road, you know, getting here. Period. You know, obviously, you always got to start with mom and dad. They got it all started. You know, the mom and dad and family and friends, you know, really made it all happen to get the thing started. Never really thought about making a living at it or doing it, you know, anywhere near the saddle. Indy was way out of my league as far as I was concerned. But it just snowballed and took its own course, and, you know, again, a lot of help and a lot of people and opportunities along the way. And, you know, obviously Bill Simpson got my foot in the door with Indy cars to begin with and convinced USAC to let this long-haired kid from California out of the desert, you know, take a shot at an oval track. And that's really what got the Indy car thing started. But then as we, you know, went through with our suit guy, Teddy Yip, and the Eagle and the McLaren, you know, basically half a season apiece. And they both ended up getting out of business, so I think I didn't do a good quite good enough job to keep them going. But so we were knocking on doors at the time, trying to make something happen. Couldn't really get anything going. And Wally Dahlbeck put on a ride up in Colorado Rockies, a motorcycle ride. And Gurney and Parnelli and, you know, a lot of the engineers, a lot of the drivers were involved in that, and they invited me to go along. So I said, okay, because I come out of motorcycles and so we went on the ride, and Roger was on the ride also. So I think that like the second day of the ride, we were getting the bikes ready to go one morning, and you know, we got to talk to each other. Roger and I parked very close to each other, we could talk to each other, and I said something, I was like, I heard you think about hiring so-and-so next year, and he said, no, not really. And he said, I heard you think about driving for so-and-so next year, and I said, no, not really. And so we talked a little more person, and he said, well, I've got something in mind. He said, give me a call before you make a deal with anybody else. Well, needless to say, I got fell over. You know, I mean, it was a huge surprise to me. So the next day or two's ride, you know, I stayed very close to Roger. If he fell off his motorcycle, I'd pick it up straight in his hand. Get him on down the trail. But that's how it all got started. And we met at the farmhouse, you know, one morning, and he told me what he had in mind. Offered a part-time ride, and I played the video for about 10 seconds. And the rest is history. That's how it all came together.
Did you ever think, though, it would amount to this?
No, I mean, it, you know, like I said, I never when we started racing, it was just a hobby. You know, it's just what we did for fun. And we worked during the week to make the means to go play on the weekend. And it really just took its own course. I can look back, you know, with hindsight and see things that happened, you know, maybe that we did that helped make it happen, but I never did it for those reasons. I was just doing what I enjoyed doing and you know, trying to compete and do the best job we could do, and it just all really snowballed into one course. So, you know, to get the opportunity with Roger and, you know, and the team and all the guys that, you know, give me the tools and the great job that they did, that's what made it all happen.
And you were a great champion once again.
Thank you very much.
Now we're going to have some fun. We want all drivers who ever competed against Rick Mears in any of his four wins to come to the stage. We're going to have you come up here, we'll seat you, and we're going to have you tell us your best Rick Mears story or whatever. Now, these are in no particular order, but I think this list includes at least most, if not all, of those who will be coming up here. They include Tom Bagley, Wally Pallenbach, Derek Daly, Dennis Firestone, Janet Guthrie, Johnny Parsons, Lobo Star J.R. Johnny Rutherford, Jerry and Tom Steva, Steve Chassie. I hope Allinger Jr. is still here. I know he had to leave early. Hopefully he's still here. Come on up, guys. Everybody to the stage as quickly as possible. Four-time winner Al Unser will be here, Pancho Carter, and Merle Bettenhouse. Now, if I did not call your name, I'm sorry, but come on up anyway, because we would like to hear from you. Look at this group, ladies and gentlemen. Again, the best that ever was. Have a seat at any order, and we've got three microphones up here, so just pass them to the person next to you when you are finished telling your story or